Call her how it is. Hendrix. I promise it's fire, so.
Metro!
Yo.
Percocet. Miley Percocet. Percocet. Miley Percocet.
Yeah.
Rep the set.
Yeah.
Gotta rep the set.
Gang, gang.
Chase a chick.
Hold up.
Never chase a bitch. Chase no bitch. Mask on.
Metro!
Fuck it, mask on.
Hold up.
Mask on. Fuck it, mask on.
Big front.
Percocet.
Set.
Miley Percocet.
Hold up.
Chase a chick. Chase. Never chase a bitch. Chase no bitch. Two cups. Toast out with the gang.
Gang.
From full steps to a whole nother domain.
We out of here.
Out the bottom. I'm a living proof. Super. And compromising half a million on the coup. Gang, gang. Drug houses found. Looking like Peru.
Order.
Graduated. I was overdue. I'm a pink money, money. I can barely move.
Yeah. Ask oh, that's your move. I be saying you do that move. Shit. That.
Red James. 33 chains.
That's your move. Hold up.
Losing biz game.
Metro!
Whoa.
That's a liability. Hit the gas. Yeah. Boosting my adrenaline. Yeah.
Percocet,
yeah.
Miley Percocet,
yeah.
Percocet,
sick.
Miley Percocet, big fine. Rep the set,
hey.
Hey.
Hey. Hey.
Yeah, 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 hey. Yeah.
Mask on,
yeah.
Mask,
yeah. 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 Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah. See right now, right now, right now, you're now tuned into $1 million worth of game.
Yes, sir. $1 trillion
worth of game. $1 trillion
worth of game. $1 trillion.
I like that. Now, 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 what's important is this. You know who we got in here?
Metro.
Listen, man, Metro Boomin with some more. We in here. Listen, man, it's going down.
You always sampling some shit and throwing some shit up in the mix.
We from Los, you know, we in Los Angeles, but. We also coming from, you know, St. Louis and Philadelphia County,
mm-hmm.
you know, to be exact, you know. You so we just in L.A. doing what we want to do.
Absolutely. And, you know,
weather.
What's so
like
crazy
that.
Is I remember when I was in prison, I was reading a Fader magazine. I was reading about how Metro mom used to take him all the way to Atlanta. I was in the penitentiary, Fader magazine. I don't know if you remember that article.
Wow. We talking about like
2016.
Right.
The article came out like 2016. I'm in the penitentiary. I'm reading that shit. And you just was like, man, I'm out here. I'm grinding, man. We getting down here. We going to fuck to the A to make it happen. And yeah. Now you done made beats for everybody.
Yeah, man. It's a blessing. It's crazy. Just, you know, how the whole shit and everything just to move and evolve.
And we ain't talking about the Illuminati. We talking about Boominati.
Oh, yeah, the Boominati.
Mm-hmm. The Boominati.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
It's all happy.
It's going down.
The Boominati. Hold on. You know. Before we go any further, this episode of $1 million Worth of Game is brought to you by New Amsterdam Vodka. He said, man, one thing about New Amsterdam, you got beats. Shit, I'm redhead to go get something because the way you be breaking that shit down, because it's superb vodka made from America's heartland.
Mm-hmm.
It's distilled 5 times, it's filtered. Uno, dos, tres, 3 times for a clean, crisp finish. Now, you can drink it straight up. You can drink it on the rocks. You can make a classic New Amsterdam mule. You can drink it while you're bumping Metro Boomin any one of his fucking hits.
Any of them.
Because that nigga got hits on top of hits on top of hits.
Yes.
And that's what you could do. Get your little cup, take a little sip. You could be doing sip on top of sips on top of sips. So when you're out and about at your local liquor store, make sure you pick you up some New Amsterdam Vodka, the official vodka of Barstool Sports and the presenting sponsor of $1 million Worth of Game. Now, I got my man in the building, Cookie yes. Face. You know, Cookie Face, you know, that was mama, you know, Miss Leslie.
Yes,
Miss Leslie used to call him Cookie Face. I'm going to call him Cookie
that's
Face.
That's my brother right there. You just seen his face when you said that shit. He's like, nigga, what the fuck?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hey, when you was just a young man, your mama used to say, Cookie Face, get the hell out of them goddamn streets. Sit and taste out them streets, Cookie Face. Did you think that you would be in this position in life? That you are now.
I mean, even from when I first started with the music back in like, I was 13.
You talk about when you was youngin', before you was Metro Boomin?
Before Metro Boomin.
When you was youngin'?
Yeah, I was young. Oh, what you know about that?
Yeah.
Oh, see, youngin', I was rapping then.
Yeah, you was rapping, yeah, when you was youngin'.
Yeah,
yeah, when I was then youngin'. You was like, you switched over and started making beats. Then you became Metro Boomin', right?
Yeah, I became Metro.
Oh, Metro.
Then niggas kept calling me Metro Beats. I ain't fuck with that. So now I was like, I need to put some kind of word on the end of it.
Okay.
And at the time, I was doing a lot of music for OJ Juice Man, mm-hmm. and closely affiliated with him. And that was just one of the things around his whole shit. He would always be like, I'm booming, I'm this, that, booming. He used to always just say that word. And I was like, fucking Metro Boomin. Just throw that shit on the end of it. And, you know, it was better off that way.
Believe that. So what made you, like, slow up on the rapping and go into more producing?
Because I feel like I always been a logical type nigga, a logical type thinker. So even back then, I knew I had fucked with rapping, and I started to rap because I wanted to make my own beats. You know, beats, shit like that costs money. You need money. I'm like, fuck it, I ain't got no money for that. I'm going to make my own shit. And then, like, just getting into the whole, first, let me tell you how I even had started to finesse it to the whole producer thing. Like, since I was young, since Nelly and them came out, Murphy Lee, St. Lunatics, I always wanted to be a rapper. I always saw that way. You know, being a rapper back then, or saying you want to be a rapper back then, is not the same as today.
No.
Right. You know, back then, you say that, your mama, your grandmama, aunties, like, nigga, like, what is you talking about? Like, right. Go to school. Yeah. Like, you tripping.
Right.
Type shit. So I had kind of finessed it to, like, ease it in, and I would always just tell them, like, I want to be a music producer, because it just sounded like some business shit or, you know, some shit like that. So I used to always just be like, I want to be a producer, but would just write my raps and shit like that on the low. But, I just got to start making my own beats and really just fell in love with that and just the process of that. And I was like, you know, if I put 100% of my time on just making beats versus trying to make beats and trying to do fucking covers and Photoshop and rap and do all this, you know, you splitting up your time and your energy. So I just put it all on making beats from then on.
Who were some of your influences coming up? As a young nigga, you know, you coming up, who did you look and say, damn, they doing it? You know, they gave you some of the fire you needed to be like, I gotta step my shit up. You would play some of your shit, then you'll hear some of their shit, you like, damn.
Yeah.
The fuck kind of machines they got over there, man? Like, who was those guys that you looked up to?
Well, inspiration-wise, I feel like I started off young. I knew I wanted to be in music. So I was in, what was that, like 2000? So I was probably like kindergarten, first grade. And Nelly had dropped Country Grammar.
Mm-hmm.
So it started at home, them St. Lunatics, like just seeing all that on TV and how it went worldwide. And they just had the whole city on smash. Like, it was crazy. And it just let me know it was possible. So just being from the same place, it let me know it was possible. And influence-wise, like, they influenced me. And I feel like the advantage of just being from somewhere like St. Louis, like, we in the middle. So it's like, it wasn't like no, like, if a nigga came up in New York or Cali and, like, this is what he on, he got Cali beats. Like, I grew up listening to all kind of shit. I love East Coast music.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I love Dipset. I love hella shit like that. At the same time, I had loved West Coast music. I grew up, Tupac was always one of my favorite all time. So much shit, you know, down south, of course, because, you know, St. Louis, like, right there, kind of like, it's like in the middle, but it's kind of down there, too. So we was just catching everything, man. Like, all the, everything that would come out, like, in St. Louis, like, niggas was just fucking with it. Because it's like, besides Nelly and them, like, you know what I'm saying? That was it. So I feel like that's why today, a lot of my music and my shit is, like, more well-rounded because I just grew up fucking with everything. Like, you know, we fuck with Lil Wayne, Cash, we fuck with everything. So even producer-wise, I came up, you know, I fuck with Dre Hard, Neptunes, 3-6 Mafia, way up there. DJ Paul and Juicy J,
yes.
You know, some of my biggest influences. I always make sure I'm always instrumental in letting people know
Hypnotized
that.
Hypnotized Minds was the shit.
Yeah, boy, ACP, like, even back then. It was crazy because, you know, hip hop was just a certain way. Like, you
What about Beats by the Pound?
Beats by the Pound down there in New Orleans. Yeah. Hell yeah. With No Limit.
No Limit.
No Limit. Beats by the Manny Pound. Fresh. Manny Fresh.
You got Jazzy Faye.
So many folks. Jazzy, that's my nigga. I fought with Jazzy Faye. Drummer Boy, Zaytoven.
Yes.
When I started to get older, it would turn into like Drummer Boy, Zaytoven, Southside.
Wait, what's my man that used to do?
Sonny.
All the tip beats, a lot of tip beats, Tump. Not all.
That was one of them. High up there on the list too with my shit. Like, it's just so many. Like, my brain's exploding trying to think of everybody. Like, but you know, I just fuck with so much shit and so many sounds. So I feel like all that played a role in shaping me today and my sound.
going to Atlanta, right? What did that do to your sound? Like going over there and fucking with the vibe there, you know?
Well, when I was younger, around that age, when I first started going to Atlanta, I was like 15. I was 15. I actually had like my 16th birthday out there too. So, I feel like I was already heavily influenced by a lot of shit going on down there. You know, I fuck with a lot of music. You know, Gucci Mane, I always been one of my favorite rappers from fifth grade. Like, so 05 from back then, like Trap House, Black T, Icy, all that shit. So from back then, Gucci, always been one of my favorite rappers. So many niggas, Tip, Jeezy, it was just so many niggas. So, so going down there and starting to fuck around, I started to, Don Cannon had reached out, you know, through somebody who used to manage me named Caveman, had reached out and was like, yo, I'm trying to fuck with you. So I started always coming down there. They had put me with Juice Man. I was just working, bro, just moving around, trying to make a name. Eventually Juice had introduced me to Gucci. And then from there, just like, you know, just kept going. And so that's establishing those type of relationships from 16 to now I'm 28. I just turned 28 last week.
So, congratulations. Happy birthday.
Man, I appreciate that.
Believe it.
Appreciate that. But yeah, bro, it was a blessing, you know, just to be around that and soak up all that game. And you got to think, even at this time when I'm down there, like, Flocka coming out, he popping, yeah. He just came out, like, all that type of shit. So I'm watching from being down there so young until now, I done seen so many niggas and watched them closely and watched all that, what they did right, what they did wrong, and their mistakes. And, you know, I just apply that to how I move today. So I feel like it influenced my sound, but also like the way I move and, you know, handle myself and conduct business and shit like that.
Now, you don't work with a lot of motherfuckers.
Yeah.
Now, we talk about your homies.
Right.
Your friends who you get in there with, you cook it up. Mm-hmm. Out of all your friends.
Oh, shit.
Who is the hardest motherfucker to work with? Like, you like, I know we about to cook some shit up, right. But it's going to be hard. Some shit that's going to go down. We going to have a little back and forth. There's always something. But we about what? At the end of the day, we make that fucking magic.
You said the hardest to work with?
Yeah. You heard what I said.
I feel like if you hard to work with, I kind of don't even want to fuck with.
Not hard, but I feel you like, you know what I'm saying. Yeah. It's always a challenge because let me just be for real. If you're working with somebody and everything is always smooth, then shit probably ain't that great. Because we got to challenge each other to be great.
Right. That's a good one. I'm going to say, it's crazy because, like, the way me and Savage work, like, at the same time, like, it's so easy at the same time, but at the same time, sometimes it's challenging.
Right.
And not challenging in a bad way. It's just I feel like we challenge each other so much.
Right.
You know, we make so much music together. We can't just be just always the same shit.
Right.
You know? It'll be nights where I'll just be going through beats and this nigga will sit and let me play 30, I promise you, 30 or 40 beats, shit like that.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about, that type of shit.
Yeah, he's one of them niggas.
See, and you sitting there, you thinking, nigga, one of these is slapping, nigga. Like,
and I just come through with the one that I just made this morning. I'd be like, oh boy, I know this is it. I know this nigga for the, he'd be like, all right, play another one.
Yeah.
I'm like, nigga. Like, oh, all right.
You already had what he was going to say on that shit.
Yeah, all that. I'm already seeing the video, nigga. Like, I be thinking that far ahead. But, you know, and I do the same in return. Like, you know, even, like, as rapping, like, maybe try this flow or do this or, you know, maybe say that slow or, you know, shit like that. Right. Like, we really got that kind of chemistry and we both respect what each other do. And they don't write and on craft or when nobody's ever offended by anything or no ego, like, you know.
Absolutely.
You know, you can't put no kind of ego in and create music.
Absolutely.
You know, I feel like that's being selfish to the music. So I feel like him, it's always easy for us as a whole, but at the same time.
He challenged you.
He challenged me, which right. I need that though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So that's a blessing.
Right. So at the end of the day, you'd be like, oh, I fucking go in here. Hope I don't got to fucking play 50 fucking beats before he pick one.
And then it be fucking me up. I hate when people be on their phone while I'm playing music. Like, whether it's a beat or even a song or anything, like, I take slight offense to that.
You just want
to
just tap on them like, hello,
So when I
got hit
beats,
records,
right? Like when I noticed the one,
stop treating me like I'm fucking Delaware Donnie.
Yeah, he the type of nigga where he always just squinting in his phone. He just like, and I'm like, nigga, I'm playing beats right now. Like, what the hell? What if you was just rapping and I'm sitting out here just looking at my phone, nigga, not listening to what you say? Right.
You sitting there like, stop treating me like College Park, Georgie. Like, I got hits out here. I didn't just start fucking making beats yesterday. Wake up, savage. He sitting there.
But it's crazy because he'll be like that. I think he's not tuned in. Then when he hear the one he fuck with, he just
fuck with that. Yeah, that's it.
Pull that up. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, in the song. So, yeah. Hell yeah.
Now, for those that don't know, name some of the artists you work with for those that don't know. That you did Top Flight production for.
I say Future, of course.
Right.
Future, Thug, 21 Savage, Travis Scott, Drake, Kanye,
nigga, after them, it's hard to remember, like, you know what I mean?
Nicki Minaj, I mean, you had some women in the mix, you know?
Okay, go ahead, nigga.
How many platinum plaques you got?
What, nigga? How many niggas he just named? All them niggas went platinum. What the fuck? He just named 10 niggas, so he at least got 10 platinum plaques. He at least got
more than that.
Diamond at the crib. God damn.
I'm not gonna lie, in Atlanta, and I'm not just saying this.
Just in Atlanta alone. Here go. Oh Lord, these Atlanta niggas love to stunt, don't
at
they?
The crib.
They
I'm
love
lying,
this.
Bro, I ain't
shit. They love to pull their pants down and say, kiss our asses.
I'm not even.
We've been the biggest motherfuckers for the last 2 decades. He about to say, in Atlanta alone, I got 45 platinum plaques.
How many you got in Atlanta alone?
I don't know. I can't even count, but I just know in my crib out there, like, there's no more room on the wall. Been ran out of room.
Just Atlanta alone.
Been ran out
so
of
you
room.
Ain't even get to Canada. You still got Drake shit sitting in the garage. That's what
nah,
the fuck.
Nah, not like artists.
That's what the fuck you gonna tell Drizzy. You got Drake shit sitting in the garage.
I'm talking about at the house. You talking about Atlanta.
Oh, no,
I'm just
talking about
the house.
About the house.
Everybody. So even like, but I feel like my biggest plaque, I got a diamond plaque for a song with Post Malone. I feel like that was crazy. Just God, even damn. See that, like, diamond, like, what the fuck?
That's major. Now, this episode of Million Dollars Worth of Game is brought to you by FTX. One thing about FTX, it used to be known as Blockfolio. FTX is the world's most popular mobile app for cryptocurrency tracking and trading. Build your portfolio and follow the prices of more than 10,000 coins. Get phone notification updates directly from the projects you care about. Buy and sell Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dogecoin, and other top tokens with absolutely zero fees. And get a free coin with every trade over $10. Visit the App Store and download FTX for free today and use code MDWOG to get $20 invested into your account. MDWOG to get $20 invested into your free account. I'm talking about your account for free. Think about that.
And everybody's into the
everybody's into cryptocurrency.
Yes.
So why not get with FTX? Go in the App Store and download it. And you know, I'm talking about this is the world's most popular cryptocurrency app for tracking and trading. I'm talking about got everything on there. Bitcoin, Ethereum, Dogecoin. Hey, I'm talking about everything is on there. What are you waiting for? Get down with, and like I said, it used to be called Blockfolio. Now it's called FTX. Get down with them. What you waiting for? Go to the App Store right now and download the app for free today, FTX. Now, we're talking about producing. That's a very lucrative sport. I'm talking about some, especially if you got your business right. And I
first
know,
thing.
And
yeah,
I,
first
listen,
thing.
Because you know, a lot of people, they come in the game, they sell a publishing. Some right. of them sell a publishing and they don't, you know, some of them get a couple dollars and they don't know that they're going to be as big as they are and shit get crazy. How did you, like, who gave you the game about the publishing, the business side of the game? Not just making a beat, but the business of beat making.
I see it all the time, but I don't know. When I was young, and I always say I want to be in music. Before I even knew what masters was or your masters was, my mama growing up, she always be like, never sell your masters. She always said it like forever. Never even knew what that shit was back then. But I feel like it was a part of just staying down and having the faith and just believing. Like, yeah, shit was hard, but it was still like I wasn't about to sell a piece of all I'm doing for some money right now. Right. I figured it out till then. You know what I'm saying? So I came in. I was blessed enough to hold on to my publishing. And yeah, I be trying to preach to niggas now, young niggas now, like, hold on to that shit. It was different back in the day. See, they used to do publishing deals back in the day, and I feel like it made more sense because you might sign with a publishing deal with a company like Sony or Universal or some shit. And they'll be like, okay, we're going to take half. That's 50%. That's half of your publishing. And on top of that, but they was taking half of your publishing, but they was actually contributing to your success in the publishing. So it's kind of justified, like, giving you placements, like, they might put you in the studio, Mariah Carey or some shit, or, you know, whatever to earn their money. But now I feel like it's so different. Like, there's no real, like, artist development and none of that going on. Everybody just vibing on the internet and shit. So, like, even back then, it's like, why am I going to sign a publishing deal with y'all when I'm making all these songs with Future and I just call him? Like, why am I going to give you half of what the fuck I'm doing and you're really not doing shit? Right. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, all my young producers, just watch out for that shit. I don't really fuck with pub deals like that, but I feel like a good admin deal is cool.
Break down an administrative deal.
See, an admin deal is, they're really like, they take a small percentage, like a real small, like I'm talking about like 8% or some little shit. And that's really just the, like, they collect your money and send it to you, like, type shit. So it's not like like a publishing deal, which really they're basically just doing that and they want half all your money, type shit. So, yeah, and if you want, you can still get an advance on that based on, like, what you done or what you got in the pipeline. Like, I remember when I was younger and back when I signed an admin deal, I had signed one, like, for a real low percentage. Like, I had waited to sign one, like, till I had hella shit. And it's like they gave me a bunch of money, but it was for a little percentage because I already had so much. So it's like they really just want to be in business with you, type right. shit. But
because they know over the long run they're gonna make all theirs back
and some. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not gonna say all publishing deals are bad. You know, it just depends on the terms of them.
Some of them give you a kickstart.
Some of them give you a kickstart for real, like for sure. Like I got like it's producers I fuck with now that I'm fucking with that like. Because, see, my mind for the whole Boominati shit and everything, like, I want to take a bunch of producers and have them all turned up, like, on some artist-level shit, like how people see me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like a bunch of Metros type shit. You know what I'm saying? So I always admire growing up, like, seeing what Ross did with MMG back then, like, with the whole Meek shit and Wale. And remember they had that period where they, it was all just like, you know what I'm saying?
It was a bunch of them. Stiley was on there. It was a bunch of them. It was deep shit.
Yeah, and it was just like,
see, Gunplay.
Because,
you know, traditionally in rap and hip-hop, it's always like artist side to artist. You got that artist, and these are kind of like the Minions type shit. You know what I'm saying? So I just respected that. Like, it just made him look like even more a boss. So I always admired that and kept that in the back of my head. So that's really what I want to do with this. And even with my shit, it's different than signing to, like, a major. Like, I'm not trying to take your beats and put my name on them and do this. And do, like, ain't nothing wrong with that. Some people do that. That's your business. But, like, you know what I'm saying? It's about you getting your just due, and I'm actually out here working and, like, getting you on all of these things to where it's like I'm not just getting something for nothing type of thing. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And I'm the type of nigga out of the business end, and people always tell me I be tripping. It's like the business end, the whole music shit, I don't never press too hard about money or no shit like that. You know what I'm saying? So I always try to keep everything in everybody else's favor. If anybody else ever feels a way or say, you know what, I don't want to do this anymore or move on, like, I just be like, yo, that's cool. You know what I'm saying? It's all good, you know? I never wanted to be one of them niggas that's like, nah, nigga, you on paperwork, you in this contract, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Let me ask you a question, personal. Answer it or don't. What's the biggest publishing check you ever got? At one time.
You know the IRS be watching this shit.
Seven figures.
I know you pay your taxes.
Nah, for sure. Definitely. Overpay them.
One
seven
time.
Figures, eight figures.
Give me a number.
Seven, man.
Damn.
All right. Let me ask you a question. Top three most talented artists you ever been in the studio with?
Oh, wow.
Oh wow, what you, this $1 million worth of game. We asked the real questions.
Yeah.
We want to know who the top three artists that you was in the studio with and you knew these motherfuckers is next level talented. You only got three. Don't try to sprinkle four in there. Three,
no,
and
I'm
going to
try to sprinkle like seven.
No,
six.
No, give us three.
I need a uno, dos, and a tres.
Man,
not
so
cuatro,
many.
Cinco,
look,
seis.
No, nobody, this is not in no order, or no, I forgot you, or no, I'm just going off the top of my head. I'm going to say Solange for sure.
Damn, I ain't never think you was going to say
wait, wait,
Beyonce's sister.
Right.
I never think you was going to say Solange.
Because like, she had, I'm not going to say surprised me like I didn't expect, but she really had like.
No, nigga, you surprised me with that motherfucking answer. I'm just saying. I'm not saying like, I'm not saying she ain't talented because I don't listen to Solange music. Shout out to Solange. You know, no disrespect to her, but you couldn't picture me riding around.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
But
yeah,
she was out of all of the motherfuckers you've been in the studio with.
I'm not saying she's just number one, but she's one of the top ones that always be in my memory because of that.
Shout out to Solange then. I got to go. I got to check her the fuck out.
Maybe it's because I ain't work with her
a lot before. I don't really bump, you know, the women like that. Yeah, he ride around all the single ladies. No, he be bumping the shit out that shit.
He lying, but go ahead.
But even with Solange, it was just like, I feel like I said it first because I ain't know it like that, so it's more of a surprise. Like, she's a true artist and producer. Like, sometimes you get in with people and they'll be a big star or whatever, and sometimes they just, they might be confused and not sure and not really know what they want or where they're trying to go, but I just respect just how her as an artist, like, she has a clear vision of what she's trying to do, what she's trying to convey, and how she's trying to get that shit across, and it was just clear, and it was just like a chemistry and like a, you know, I just respect the whole, you know, her whole artistry behind that.
Give us another one.
What's the question again? It was like,
What was the question again?
So what'd you say? Most impressed? I'm just trying to get the specific.
I said, who was the most talented?
Talented. Okay. That was the word.
Top three artists that you got in the studio with and they was the most talented. And your first answer was Solange. Your second answer?
Shit, why y'all doing this, bro?
I'm just saying, you've been in there with some talented motherfuckers.
That shit
bro.
Hard
it's
for him.
Like,
that shit hard, bro.
It's not that hard, man. You've been in there it with is. Talented, but all of them is talented. Let's just say that. All of them are talented.
I
don't
want to put it like I'm saying this person.
Say, no, you. I just want to say.
They more
no.
talented.
Oh, come
and
on.
And them,
man. Oh, man.
You know, artists sensitive about their shit, bro.
What is they? Somebody going to be calling him. Damn, you ain't say me. That's
I'm
going to
get
crazy.
A call for this shit come out. Get a call today.
Damn, this shit, man. Damn.
So you can't answer that question?
I can. I'm going to say, I'm definitely going to put Future in there for sure.
Okay, Future. And one more. It's not that serious, bro. It's really not that serious. You got Solange, Future.
The Weeknd.
Damn.
Because I didn't even mention him earlier.
You ain't mentioned him with the people you did.
So I'm going to say him.
Fucking kill him. All right, now, this is a very important question because you got a lot of dudes out there that say they producers and they're. What is the difference between a beat maker and a producer?
Man, I'm glad you asked that because I feel like today it's a common like misconception of that shit.
Yeah.
A beat maker is somebody who strictly makes beats. So you might be in the room, you making beats all day, and like that's strictly what you're doing. You're making beats. Like you're not really dealing with no sessions or no vocals or really no artists directly or, you know, none of that type shit. Like you're making beats and either sending them off or giving them to somebody and they do make the song happen. Now, a producer, which are some producers actually make beats and some don't. A producer is somebody who sees the song out from the beginning to the end to make sure it's the best thing that it could be. That's the true definition of a producer. So whether it's coming in with the artist, getting them fired up, like motivating them and putting the right beat on, then they got the right beat on, then it's like you might help with what kind of direction are we going in or just like a coach kind of, like all the way through. You know what I'm saying? So it's like that type of thing. And then even after the artist recorded their vocals, you might go through and be like, okay, these four or eight bars, maybe we could have did this better or do this over. It was riding until this point. Just do that shit over. Little shit like that. You might go back in and put an orchestra on the shit or get somebody to play guitar on it or just all kinds of shit. Get the song mixed, master everything. Just see it all the way to the end just to make sure it's the best it could be.
Yep.
Now, when you talking about going into producing, you know what I mean, making these beats, whatever you doing, you digging in the crates heavy?
Man, the crates to the left of you.
Oh, you do. You digging in there heavy?
Yeah, dude got heavy. Crates over there.
Heavy. But see, on the back end, don't that sting when you sampling shit up?
It do, but I feel like with music, I love the art, so I've never been motivated by the money aspect of it. So like the sampling or having somebody else play some piano or some shit on them, like I don't really care about none of that. I just want this shit to be
as hot as it could possibly be. Yeah. And have my name attached to it.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Just the I feel like at me doing music and being a producer, I look at it like God blessed me with my ear and this gift to not just use it for myself and my own personal gain, but to like be a servant. Like I feel like I'm a servant to the people. Like it's a service. You know what I'm saying? To bring people this music that, you know, might change your day or make you feel better or do this or that. So I really always put the music first. It's before me. I never try to involve me or try to put me ahead or be selfish to the music. I be calling that like being selfish to the music. Like you can't never be selfish.
This episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is also brought to you by Roman Focus. One thing about Roman Focus, the Roman in-house team of doctors obsessively research ingredients to formulate a high quality supplement with the ingredients to support focus and concentration. One thing about this, listen, I'm talking about caffeine and I'm talking about this Roman Focus works within 30 to 60 minutes. With calm energy effects you can feel from the first dose. Just two capsules deliver about the same amount of caffeine as one cup of coffee. I'm talking about Roman Focus is not playing no games. I'm talking about, and the way you get this, you got to go to GetRoman.com/game and get $15 off your first order of Roman Focus. I'm talking about $15. And guess what? This statement has not been evaluated by the FDA. This product is not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any diseases. But one thing about Roman Focus, like I said before, this
get
thing,
your focus.
I'm
you be like
about,
this.
This thing will have you focus, concentration. I'm talking about next level. With Roman, you'll get free 2-day shipping and automatic refills.
That's how focused you'll be.
I'm talking about, yeah, that's how they plan. So it's one less thing to think about. Not playing no game. Roman Focus. You got to get your mind right. You know, Metro, he had Roman Focus up in him and he making them top flight beats and have his game to another level. Just imagine what he'd do with Roman Focus on you. Go to GetRoman.com/game and get $15 off your first order of Roman Focus. What are you waiting for? Roman Focus.
Your top five artists in the land of all time.
Oh, my God. You're killing him. You fucking killing this boy. Shit. I love it. Keep the fire on him. Keep that fire on him, Gil.
Come on, we're going to throw Future in there. One.
Yeah, you gotta put Pluto in there, I ain't gonna lie.
You gonna put Future and Savage from the rip.
Two.
All right, look, you said that, I ain't say that.
Oh, damn, hold on, we gonna put Future in there.
That's my boy. But I know him, like, he don't give a fuck about being considered, like,
none
the
of
top
that.
Five artists.
No, I ain't life. Say what he consider, I said you know what's yours. Yeah. So Future is one, go ahead, what's your number two?
I'm gonna say Pluto, because, you know what I'm saying, he definitely, he transformed this shit. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it was a co-op, like him and Thug. I feel like I'm going to tie them as one. Future and Thug, we're going to say that's one. Guwop, he's like, it's a tree. Like,
this nigga putting two niggas as one?
It's like
he making up his own rules. I'm putting Guwop in. Who I can throw in there with Guwop?
Yeah.
To him and they two, like, you going to end up with 10 niggas. What a low.
It's so many niggas, but
so you got Future, you got Thug.
You said the top.
Your top. Future, top, Thug. Like your top. Future, Thug, Guwop. Just two more.
I'm trying to think of some back then shit. Tip.
Tip. One more.
Can't forget Tip.
That shit hard, fucking with Atlanta.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Oh, like, it's generations of that shit. Like, this shit go from back in the day.
Sounds like you're making up excuses.
Man, I'm known for that. But, let me see. Fuck.
I ask you, if I ask you the top five women in your life, is you gonna put your first girlfriend Deanna in there? No.
Oh, see, now you try to hide that.
When she broke your little heart.
Broke his heart, fucked him up. He started making beats.
That's when you start making beats. Shout out to Deanna.
You birthed this boy beats. He's like, I gotta come up. I gotta get it.
Deanna. Hold on, I just thought about it. I just thought about the name y'all said, Deanna.
Yeah.
What y'all know about Deanna?
Yeah, Deanna, the birth of his beats. That's the birth of Metro Beats. Together. Fuck this little heart up. He stayed in the crib for 2 years.
I'm gonna come up. I'm gonna pay her back.
Bro, I was like 11, nigga.
Got you.
I know, that's when you start making beats.
Well, I thought you said a random name.
Cheat on you?
I thought
she cheated on you,
nigga. Fuck, what'd you
she
think? Do? Yeah, she cheated on you.
I don't even remember what
you
it was.
You remember what she did to your little heart up.
And dramatic, it's just like.
She took another nigga's milk at lunch.
My ass bought a pizza on Friday.
Milk at lunch. Seeing back then, it used to be little shit like that. You thinking about that
she
shit.
She took another
night.
Nigga milk at lunch, tore his little heart up.
Fuck
you, Mom. Mom, I don't want to go outside of work. Give me a beat machine. Shut up, Cookie Face. Please, Mom, give me a beat machine. Get Cookie Face a beat machine.
And it was crazy because I had always liked Deanna. Then I remember in fifth grade, like her and her mama or whatever, they had moved to the same apartments as us. So then we used to be playing outside and. What's that game niggas used to play back in the day?
Hot Freak,
getting,
nigga. You remember what you used to
play? Yeah, all them type games. All that high and go get it. Like, what's the other name? Like, the other game.
Catch a girl, get a girl.
Yeah. What was that?
Not
flashlight. It was some shit.
She brought back memories to that motherfucker. Fucked him up.
That was back in the day, bro. That was back
in the
day.
She still fucked him.
You ever run into her again?
It was like probably in like, I think ninth grade.
She was still glowing when you...
Yeah, you know.
Give her props. Don't hate her.
Nah, I'm not hating. Nah, I'm not hating.
Cause she was glowing in the fifth grade.
Oh, she was overglowing.
Oh, she was glowing. He was like, she's not real.
And then I ain't definitely hating. Like, I was just trying to remember. But ninth grade, she was still fine.
Yo, you love hard, bro.
That's good.
What's your sign?
Wow, not out of that shit.
No, I don't want your sign.
I'm a Virgo. So
I'm a Virgo.
Whatever that means.
He said, I'm a Virgo. Talking about what's the sign. Nigga, what you gonna ask him? His color next? What's your favorite color?
Right. Like, I feel like he's trying to wind and dime me, nigga. Like, he's like,
what the fuck? You courting some niggas?
No, you know, girls is into that. What's his sign? You know, we don't just entertain for a bunch of dicks. I just hope you know. We do got women out there that love us, too.
That. You're right. They want to know a nigga's sign.
They do.
Virgo.
You know what I mean? I don't give a fuck about his sign. I got Tootie, nigga. You ever seen Tootie?
Yeah.
Fuck is wrong with you? I'm cool. Fuck is wrong. But we had, like, that lovely lady right there, she might have wanted to know what his sign was. You know, damn, I never knew he was a
Virgo. She know his whole life.
Exactly.
She know his whole life. I heard her in here talking, yeah, because he wears size shoe, this, then the third, his size shoe, his drawers is this, then the third, his legs is this long, he got his braids is this long, yeah, he like his braids dyed on the end. She know his whole fucking life. You know what I mean? She like executive personal assistant or some
let
shit.
Let me just tell you something, though. You got to start being more female sensitive, bro. Every time I ask a question pertaining to the ladies, you always say, fuck is you asking that type of question for? Dog, we got female listeners, too.
I know.
Right.
We not just doing this for greatest for a prison.
Yeah, all right, but I don't know what the fuck you're talking about.
And Dallas the Prink Palace.
I knew he was going to go to the prison.
You know what I mean? We not just doing this for Fulton fucking County. Fulton County fucking correctional facility, that's what it's called.
Oh, he's on Rice Street. He's on right in Atlanta.
Nigga, fuck's wrong with you? Like, Fulton we County. Got women, too, that we, you know, they want to know about the nigga. You know what I mean? Just in case, you know, his high school sweetheart, you know, mess up or something. Don't mess up. You got a good one. Shit. You know what I mean? You got a good one right here.
You feel me?
You got a real one.
You know what I mean?
This episode of $1 Million Worth of Game is also brought to you by Ship Station. One thing about Ship Station, I don't care what you got going on. I'm talking about something. With over 100,000 sellers use ShipStation. I'm talking about over 100,000. Think about that. That's how many people is using ShipStation to get their products moved around. I'm talking about easily import orders from any sale channel.
Anywhere.
I'm talking about automates just about any shipping task. Spend less time sorting through orders and more time doing what you do best. ShipStation integrate all selling channels into one simple dashboard so you can seamlessly connect carriers, print shipping labels, and get products out the door fast. That's one thing I like. I'm talking about Fortune 500 companies with ShipStation. Small businesses can now access the same rates usually reserved, like I said, for Fortune 500 companies. So what are you waiting for? You need to get with ShipStation. What you need to do is go to ShipStation.com, click the microphone at the top, and enter ShipStation. Make ship happen. That's what you need to do. When you go to ShipStation, you make ship happen. This is the real deal. I don't care how big or small your business is. I don't care. You ship just station. Started. ShipStation will bring your stuff to life and do the thing for you. What are you waiting for? Get with ShipStation.com right now. Make ship happen.
Make ship happen.
Man, I just thought about it. You know, them ads that y'all be doing, that shit be like, it just reminded me of, you know, them infomercials. Like before, not even the infomercial. You know, you be up late watching TV and you think, you try to see what's on TV and you try to see if it's just a commercial or infomercial. And every time you think it's about to be over, it keep going. But you still stick around.
Because like, you know why we make shit happen.
This just might be a commercial. Nah, I fuck with that though.
Yeah, but no, like at the end of the day, like.
Now, what we need you to do, you want? Can you make shit happen?
We need him to make shit happen. We need him to make a beat.
Mm.
Is he redoing a beat or is he showing the layers of a beat? What is he? Is he doing a beat from scratch? Because I make beats too with this. I know how to make some shit like.
Metro!
Shit, see, this shit loud, ain't it?
Loud as a motherfucking, bust my fucking eardrums, man.
I mean, shit, y'all talking about the crates. I could probably dig in the crates just and do something.
All right, well, listen.
Just make it happen.
Dig in the crates and make that sound. Let me dig in the crate.
All right, pick whatever you want to pick.
I go over here and pick a record.
So they know this shit ain't pre, whatever. Just pick whatever.
Oh, that's beautiful. Look, go look at all the records, too. Yeah, get him on. Yeah,
I see what's on there right now. I think it's Miles Davis. What's on there right now?
Tell me my song is on here. Yup. I got one right here, main source. This is right here. Hold up, let me put this back on.
Let me see what it got.
This is from my ear right here. And can I play this? Can I play this record? Is from my ear. This is a rap group called Main Source. They had a major song called Looking at the Front Door.
I'm looking. Okay. I'm looking at the front door. Boom, 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 boom.
It's been a while. Hold on. Is it in here?
I'm looking at the front door.
Boom, right here. Boom. Here we go, right here.
That's what the hook was like.
Yeah.
Look at. Damn. Look.
Oh, damn. That shit hard.
So, how do I. Is this. How you want to put this on?
So, you take that one off.
Let's do this. I used to be a DJ too, but I did DJs with tapes.
Okay. Oh shit.
Yeah, he was DJing Excuse in prison me. And shit. DJ Loose Cheeks.
Now where do I go at?
Pause.
No, that was his name. No,
watch it, Gil. We doing some music shit.
Yes, see, we giving you a live, you know, representation of what this look like when you got one of the biggest producers in the game making a beat, you know, we just stepped off.
Metro!
We let him do his thing for, you know, I don't know if it took him 10, 15, 20 minute maximum, and he come right back with this hot shit that fast, just like he told us he would do. You feel what I'm saying? And we always motivate the rappers, so we just wanted to motivate the producers one time. And hopefully one day y'all be sitting right here with me and Wallo making the beat as well. You know, being celebrated as well. We just want to get this young man his flowers, cause he's still young and he doing his thing out here. You feel what I'm saying? And he the shit, and he work hard to be the shit. And we just wanted to show you he was the shit by him just lacing this motherfucking beat like this for y'all. You feel what I'm saying? Hey, we might use this beat. Let some young niggas freestyle off this shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, what's up?
You know what I'm saying? Hold on. Play it back. Hold on, fuck it. Let some young niggas freestyle off this shit. Let some young niggas freestyle off this. Go ahead, Wallo. Spit something, Wallo.
I'll let you spit.
Dog, you ain't gonna spit nothing.
No, I'm holding my shit.
Between the weed and the liquor, hitting the cars and the ice, and the women and them flights, and them long Vegas nights. Niggas stay dripping with that Gucci on. Bitches in them Louis Vuittons. When your money right, that bring the groupies on. Move along. I don't need them, I ain't even bragging, nigga. I done had more bitches than you could imagine, nigga. I pull up in that Aston right. You should see them Aston light swagger right. Money's on my appetite. I'm in the streets chasing it. Y'all niggas faking it. I'm trying to get liquor rich. I be chasing money. Nigga, I don't chase a bitch, but they chase Gilly though. I done locked Philly though, really though. 24/7, always on my grind. So that mean that paper, nigga, always on my mind. Spent a pretty penny on the shine. Gotta count a quarter mil up. I need a little time. Shit. Let some young niggas freestyle off this shit. You know what I mean?
Metro!
Let some young niggas freestyle off this Metro shit. And I was just
Metro!
Talking a little shit off the, you know, real quick. But we just blessed y'all real quick with this motherfucking Metro Boomin. Hit that shit one more time for him, Wallo.
Metro!
It is just like that, nigga.